Wedwa wako marido, wedwa wako marido. I wanna take you to my home.
Hello you guys and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Hey, how are you? My name is Gandani Carlton and welcome back. It has been quite a minute. I will not lie, but we're back and today we are making the most fluffy buttermilk American pancakes. And wait, before I handle that, I'd like to excuse this little background here. I'm trying to find some sort of Gandani Carlton space where I'll be doing all my intros and like sit down videos, you know, some sort of that. So you'll have to deal with this for now, but I'm working on something, so do not worry. So today we're making fluffy buttermilk pancakes, and I put out a poll on, I showed a mini tutorial on my WhatsApp status a while back, and some people really
paid. No pancakes, Atari.
Like this one, who looks like he was cooking the fires of hell. And then some others did a decent job, and to them we applaud, we give them the credit. So yes, that is that. So today I'm giving you a step-by-step tutorial on how to make perfect fluffy pancakes, like pancakes that are thick, you know, thick and fluffy and light and everything. So yeah, enjoy the pancakes. Enjoy the okay, cute.
Shaking, palms are sweaty. Now hammer. Stomach is churning, heart is burning, wondering what I had to eat lately. I've been feeling weak and hardly.
All right, let's get started on these pancakes. I began by measuring out by two and a half cups of flour, and I know that when you're using cups to measure flour, you're supposed to spoon it in, but ain't nobody got time for that. I just poured it in, nikamwaga yote ndani, and we move on with our lives. Yes. So I put that in and I generously sprinkled sugar. This is where just your taste buds your taste buds zina determine how much sugar you want. Kuna wale wanapenda kidogo na mimi ni napenda zaidi. So I just put on almost the entire bowl of sugar, but we will move on regardless. Diabetes ni mimi nitapata, sio wewe. So do not ask me. And then I added one teaspoon of baking powder and a very generous half teaspoon of baking soda, because baking powder has cream of tartar and baking soda, and then baking soda is just pure baking soda. So like, you want that acidity to increase, you know, so that like you get that fluff and lightness, you know what I mean. Yes, you do. At this point I was about to add my cinnamon, but then I realized that I had bought cardamom instead because my dad bought this weird brand and now I couldn't differentiate, and so I had to go back to the kitchen feeling stupid, feeling very stupid. and take the actual thing, which is cinnamon, which I sprinkled very generously because the smell of cinnamon is actual heaven. Don't even argue that. The smell of cinnamon is in heaven. Kama utafika utaniambia. So, wow, I was looking for my whisk, for my balloon whisk to come and mix this. Where is this whisk, by the way? Oh, and only to find that the whisk was just hapo kando, just beside me. And so I gave it a very vigorous whisk, a very vigorous whisk to make sure that all the dry ingredients are incorporated. And I came in with a clean bowl to commence on my wet ingredients. But you need to start with your buttermilk, because these are buttermilk pancakes, and you can make your own by using some 1.5 cups of milk, and to which you're going to add vinegar. I don't even measure the vinegar because I used to have this thing where I really love vinegar. Like, there's just, whenever I'm adding vinegar to salads or anything, I put loads of it. I can even drink vinegar. This kamwasho, the way it chokes you, yani, that vinegar, well, it feels so nice. It's this sensation that it brings when you eat it. But anyway, enough vinegar talk. You leave that for 3 minutes and pour in your melted butter into your bowl. This is your liquid gold. Okay, you're not supposed, it's not a must, but like, I feel like the melted butter adds in flavor, and this is a very crucial step. You're supposed to separate your egg yolks and your egg whites, because the egg whites have a different component that when you mix them together, it just spoils, and it, and you won't get the same lift when you mix them together. So yeah, you separate them, and like, some people will tell you to whip your egg whites to achieve stiff peaks, but I experimented juicy, and like, it doesn't even matter. The components of the egg whites ziko bado. And anyway, who wants to crank up the hand whisk, the hand mixer at 7 a.m. in the morning? People are sleeping. People are not in the mood for noise. You yourself can barely see. So who wants to crank up the mechanisms? So you just separate. And I usually use the shells to separate them. People say you can use your hands. I've tried that, but you can too. You know what? You do you. Separate your egg whites the way you want. And no, I went to dispose that, and I came back to whisk my egg yolks and my, what was that, melted butter, you know, to make sure that I get a nice homogeneous mixture, to which I came and added a very generous dazzle of vanilla essence, because you can never go wrong with vanilla essence. You can never go wrong with vanilla essence. Ah, the smell of it. So I give it a generous whisk. Make sure everything is well incorporated. Make sure everything is together. Make sure everything is together before you come and add in your buttermilk, which is supposed to be ready in 3 minutes. So I came and poured in my buttermilk, aka the only white thing that we're allowed to be pouring during this quarantine. Yes, I see you. You right there with your Arimis, and you do not own a cow. Repent your sins. Repent your sins, oh sinner. Go, hey. Repent. We know loneliness will kill you, but still repent. Rudi kwa Mungu. Stir, whisk your liquids. Make sure that you get a nice homogeneous, wow, I feel like I'm just repeating this statement all throughout this tutorial, like, whisk, get a nice homogeneous mixture. But yes, that is all it is. It's a very simple recipe, and like, after this, you're just going to bring back your dry ingredients and pour in your wet inside them, and make sure you get every last drop of it, because yeah, the economy is bad, and you do not want to be wasting 3 drops of white substance buttermilk. So yes, you koroga using a rubber spatula so that you do not incorporate too much air. Just fold it in gently until it looks roughly mixed. You do not even need to go all smooth and whatnot, because you'll be ruining it or something. Do not incorporate too much air. That's why you're not even using a mixer. So after this, I think I even mixed it for too long. You're supposed to now add your liquid gold, which is also your egg whites, the star ingredient, the thing that will give this thing that lift, that rise, that tendon you need, that will make you go and just like incorporate it in. Make sure you do not see, as in until you do not see it, make sure ime ingia ndani kabisa, ingia ndani 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 ndani, and whatever you guys like saying. And now we go to cook. Yes, mapishi haya, mapishi tayari. You light your fire, which is as transparent as your will to live, as your sense of humor, as your hope of having a nice face, as your beauty. Pole, I'm roasting myself. So you add in some kabata, some tsubata, and melt it inside there. Make sure, because it's going, I don't like cooking with vegetable oil because it is somehow like donuts. So use butter or blue band, but again blue band tastes like plastic, but wow. Okay, then add one hefty scoop of pancakes because you did not work all that time to make bite-sized pancakes. But there's this trend going online that people are making pancake cereal, and there's this thing: the first one will always burn, the first one will always ungua. If your first pancake does not burn, you are a mchawi, you are a witch doctor, and the devil is whom you worship. Like me, my first one always unguas, so that one was burnt, and you can see the smoke that is coming off of there. But now we will continue cooking. I'm supposed to cook 2 minutes on the 2 to 3 minutes on the first side, and about 1 minute on the second side. And as you cook that, here comes Carlton with another rant. Here comes Carlton with another rant.
So there is this behavior that has been brought about by quarantine. This devil that we want to condemn, where people with their 2,000, 3,000 followers feel like suddenly they are Kim Kardashian, they are celebrities, and they attempted to click that live button on Instagram. My friend, if you're live there with an audience of 3 people, you and a fellow fool discussing things that you could have done in your private conversations, by the way, you are the trash. Kick yourself out. Kick yourself out. This is the devil these are demons that we do not want during this quarantine. You are not famous. Just humble yourself down. Calm down. Who are you going live for? I am tired of seeing your ugly faces. Two people discussing nonsense. I said, the day was how the day, telling, reading the comments for the whole thing. For the whole set. Mannerless.
Either way, let us go to more positive vibes. This pancakes are everything, and by now, my friend, if you have not subscribed, you are not doing me justice, because these pancakes are the bomb. These pancakes are the bomb. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Hey, look at this babies. By the way, hey, these pancakes are literally everything. I kid you not, my friend, you wish you were right here. You wish you were right here enjoying this delicacy with me, but circumstances do not allow. So stay your ass indoors and follow this recipe for the most foolproof fluffy pancakes. Oh my gosh, I'm telling you, just looking at them. God, I am literally dead. Just look at that syrup. Ooh, that is literally the chef's kiss, baby. Ooh, 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 ooh. And this is literally all you need right now during these trying times. The depression is creeping in. The anxiety is on the door. And you just want to dance to pata pata and eat your pancakes and feel the cool vibes, because sometimes you just need to eat, have some ginger tea on the side, that you infused with some lemon, and ooh, 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 ooh. These pancakes are gonna hit. Oh my gosh, if you're feeling this right now and you're not in the kitchen going to prepare, what is wrong with your life?
And so guys, guys, that was the video. Oh my gosh, those pancakes were amazing. Those pancakes were the bomb. I can't even express it. So yeah, make sure to subscribe for more content like this. Click that subscribe button. Happy subscribe. You must subscribe, like, and engage with me in the comment section. And if you want more content like this, if you want to keep it Kandali culture, and be sure, yeah, to follow me on IG as Kandali culture. And I will see you in the next video after you have given me ideas. I wish I thought this intro and outro out.